Welcome to the session of Overview of Design Thinking. Design thinking belongs to the second phase of UX lifecycle. Design thinking is the mindset in which a product concept and design is created for giving a better user experience along with good emotional impact and good interaction, which goes into long-term memory of the user. When we talk about design thinking as a design paradigm, which we have discussed in the earlier sessions, we can say that design thinking is immersive, which means that a person will get completely lost in the product till the task is not done. So design thinking can help us in making the system immersive. We can also say that design thinking is integrative, which means that we do integrate the analysis, creativity, and innovation to bring out the best. Design thinking is also said to be market oriented. As we can see an example of iPhone iPad, which says that it is designed by Apple. The Apple iPod Touch is an example of a product resulting from design thinking. The device has superb usability, its soft buttons have precise and predictable labels. The packaging, gift wrapping, and engraving appeal to a personal and social desirability. It is attractive, it is delightful. The user experience is everything, and everything is about design. In fact, the label device does not say made by Apple, it says designed by Apple. You buy it for what it can do, but you love it because it is so cool. Design thinking is also an eclectic blend of art, craft, science, and invention. In the design thinking perspective, you are more likely to hear the terms such as create, ideate, craft, envision, interpret, excite, provoke, simulate, and empathize. Let us consider our three design perspectives which we need to consider while designing. The three design perspectives are ecological perspective, interaction perspective, and emotional perspective. Let us see one by one. When we say ecological perspective, we see about how our system will work in the given external environment. In other words, we can say that when we deploy the product or give it for testing in its actual environment where the product will be used, how will it work there? The second perspective is interaction perspective, where we see how are the users going to interact with the system or the product. Are the users going to do the task right? Are the users clicking on the proper buttons, etc.? The third perspective is emotional perspective, where we see various emotions of the user while using the product or the system. It could be happy, joy, sad, etc. For example, if the user is using the new car, he might be excited, happy, and the ride might be thrilling to the user. So all this becomes the emotional perspective of the user for using the car. Let us come to the next important topic, that is user persona. User persona is an imaginary person which has specific characteristics and specific work role. When I say specific characteristics, it means that a persona has a name, life, and personality, etc. What will happen if we do not use persona while designing or sketching or writing storyboard? If there is no persona, then we do not know who the users are, what skill they possess, so it will be completely designers thinking about design and they will make it considering themselves as the user. So the designing could be vague or ill-defined. With persona, the struggle of designing for conflicting needs and goals of different user classes can be mitigated. Persona will help in designing for various groups of user classes with specific characteristics. Following are the characteristics of an effective persona. First, we need to focus on one persona at a time. The reason for doing this is that if we create multiple persona at the same time, then we might forget to add some important features or characteristics of the persona, or maybe we might create ambiguous persona which has no relevance in the system. Second, the persona should be believable by everyone, very precise with the characteristics, and everyone should believe in that persona as if it is a real person for whom we are defining. The story writer of the movies first create personas of the characteristics and then select the actors which suit best for that specific character. Third, make your persona memorable. It should be there in the long-term memory of the user. And the last, persona works best when there is some commercial products to be made. If the product or the system is small, there might be not multiple personas required. Let us see the stages for creating persona. In the first stage, we gather data for persona. This takes a lot of time and effort. The second stage is analyzing the gathered data for creating more specific and precise person and to remove the ambiguity, if any. The third stage is to refine the characteristics to fit in the system or product and finalize the actual persona. There is an example of specific persona for a commercial of coffee shop marketing, where a student named Sarah, who is 20 years old, working as an interior designer student, is looking for a place where she can relax, study, feel better. So she might go for a coffee shop for a new experience. Let us see some other parameters which are related to design thinking. A user's mental model is a description of how the system works as held by the user. A designer's mental model is a vision of how a system works as held by the designer. It is the job of conceptual design to connect the two. Ideation is applied design thinking, where we design the ideas using sketching or listing it with sticky notes. The two modes of ideation are ideation creation and ideation critiquing. Critiquing means reviewing or evaluating the ideas by having brainstorming session without any argument or fight. Last, we come to sketching, which is a form of freehand drawing. It is used for exploring the ideas and expanding them. It is not same as the storyboard. A lot of sketching and storyboard is needed before making interaction, design or sheet to save time and work. Thank you.